Scientists have learned a lot about how southern resident orcas catch fish at the surface during the day. But what happens at night or deep down in Puget Sound where humans can't follow?
So we wanted to understand how they catch fish underwater. They go on these deep dives to find salmon that are 100 to 600 feet underwater.
Jennifer Tennyson led recent research using tags that record behavior. They're attached to the orcas using suction cups. Then scientists link the behavior recordings with sounds the whales are known to make when they catch a fish.
We noticed that they tend to roll on their sides. They accelerate and decelerate quite often, and they swim in a really non-directional pattern. And so that combination of movements is how we were able to determine that fish were captured. And so we then looked for those movements across all of the dives that we had in our data set. And every time those movements occurred, we knew that a fish had been captured.
They found that males hunt more often than females and also do the majority of salmon catching, but they also may be sharing what they catch, so scientists aren't sure males eat more than females. But they were also able to see when the orcas hunted and came up empty.
There are several deep dives that don't appear to be successful fish captures.
The southern resident killer whales are at historic lows, with just 75 left alive in the wild. Food is a major problem, as the whales mostly eat salmon, and their favorite food, Chinook salmon, is also disappearing. That's the next step for the research. Now that scientists know how the whales hunt, they want to find out how humans might be interfering, especially with boat noise. In Seattle, I'm Allison Morrow, King 5 News.